Esker Maraivola Agus Falcha Ran Ues Rèidio Albannach Astràilia-a-Deas Ek Coig EBI in your Tripunkan FM Digitach EBI Wordno Srik Ed Mlinia Is Misha Renich Nichgeri. Good afternoon and welcome to Scottish Radio Hour here at 5 EBI 103.1 FM or Digital EBI World. My name is Rachel Hay and a special welcome to anyone listening from further afield with our streaming service at www.5ebi.com.au. Kimaraha Shevandu, how are you today? I'm well, although busy having a trunk. I guess if he's Akavula Gavelmi asked, Alan in America Toe, Mashin, Shah Agav, and Leechish Va America. I am still in the US. I had my fingerprint scanned last week, so things are moving on with the immigration. But that means this is your monthly letter from America.
Back to a dying country friend, 'cause we're hearing our
I've moved to America. Do you know who else has moved to the Americas? A young osprey born last summer in Renfrewshire, who has appeared on an island in Barbados. No, yelada ielske anum Barbados a mia sha. Ach hashen merivel chach hash skask and drugig and yelada uskat anan shenamak rein fru. Hashet the keel hook and jach and yelada ielskir habarach ger kehish mila milchen. No, sheer mila kilometren gu le. She covered a journey of more than 4,000 miles, or 6,500 kilometres, in her journey, and it's thought to be the first time a UK osprey has been seen in the Americas. Ospreys in the UK have received individual coloured bracelets since the 1960s, which means that humans are able to track their lifespans and migrations. Ha yelaren iasgid ansan riach gernichte erfan shen dach she ayan, vachion ker fichat bliena. Agus le shin, bi fisek dernia, che choes da hagach che agus kachavelet dol. Mara shemplis, bi che a dol van helenin canary, gach gyauri, a alpa, agus fionella, is dol as an rioch geniche, ran costa, jej is rana. Ach, ha shon chied tares a chunicher yelere iaskid, as an rioch geniche, ans na hamerageen. For example, one osprey goes to the Canary Islands every winter, while others have migrated from the UK to the Ivory Coast and Ghana. But this is the first time an osprey from the UK has been seen in the Americas. Earlier this month, conservationist Tim McCrill was contacted by a colleague, Michael St. John, who had photographed a female osprey with a blue ring, photographed at Borden's Irrigation Pond in the north of Barbados. Amir Shachai Ur Nyech Gletiches Michael St. John Jalov Ye Yelada Iaskit Erevel Fanya Gerem Lega Fise Tim Makrel Aunun Alpa Gundure and Jalov Shin Aunum Barbados. Hunnehe an Erna Yelada Uske Aunzen Ellen Aunun Dava A Chabberin Ha and Fanya Levig Ekanam Shin. Mr. St. John said he has seen the same osprey 6 miles away from in late October, but hadn't been able to read the ring at the time. The osprey in question is thought to have left Scotland in late August or early September last year. And that is an bioch gan drach an yelere eske alpa an an yche nio salting an uri. Be yelere an eske asan fienelon a dol gach yawri ag Africa a jes. Aha nas aach e falof ach bishin har talof. Eron wa vela chai an yelere eske sio har chuain. Habbering y shin a yena vown in Casavan, Marshin haluch glaitikish and biach gundravi anav erbartikin, as is a doll. While some Finnish ospreys regularly cover a greater distance to South Africa for winter, that is mostly overland. Well, this Scottish osprey travelled mostly across the Atlantic. She wouldn't have been able to cover the distance in a single flight, so it's thought that she rested on boats on the way. The bird appears to be very settled, and will probably remain in Barbados for the foreseeable future. Ha colosan gavel an yelere eske guma corostel an Barbados agus can be an son an alm re chach agus an lacking sinish orang ella a huanchen marshin jamien colin vich calaman a shane hawks and eagles. It's time for another song, so let's listen to the McCalmans singing Hawks and Eagles.
I was walking down the road, I met my brother with a heavy load. I said to him, what have you seen? He said to me, I have a dream.
In 1960 I thought I died in Sharpville's bloody town, but I got up and I walked on tall, nobody's gonna put me down.
Hawks and eagles fly like doves, hawks and eagles fly like doves, hawks and eagles fly like doves, hawks and eagles fly like doves.
As I walked out along the way, I saw my sister bend and pray. I said to her, why do you kneel? She says, you don't know how I feel. I had a little boy and a little girl, I loved to watch them grow. But they were butchered on the streets in the blood and soul went told.
Hawks and eagles fly like doves, hawks and eagles fly like doves,
Hawks and eagles fly like doves. Hawks and eagles fly like doves.
It's 85 and I'm walking still across the Yuttantaka hills. Saw clouds set off at the dawn of day. The soldiers said, don't come this way.
Then somebody threw a stone as they walked up the track. A boy on a bike was the first to fall with a bullet in his back.
Hawks and eagles fly like doves. Hawks and eagles fly like doves. Hawks and eagles fly like doves. Hawks and eagles fly like doves.
It's been a
long, long, hard road. 300 years since settlers rode into that southern land. Now they rule with an iron hand.
Back they say,
but the hawks and eagles will fly like doves when the people rise one day.
Hawks and eagles fly like doves. Hawks and eagles fly like doves. Hawks and eagles fly like doves. Hawks and eagles fly like doves.
Hawks and eagles fly like doves. Hawks and eagles fly like doves. Hawks and eagles fly like doves. Hawks and eagles fly like doves.
Ha, nature scotte, kedicus a horse to fach nashinta a vunny ruai, gus agus project saving wildcats. Nature Scot have approved a license to the Kangwams National Park and the Saving Wildcats project to release captive bred Scottish wildcats in the park. There will be a series of trial releases in June, with the hope that up to 20 wildcats will eventually be released annually. Bien da vuyun a legal cat yarich avach ans a fark, bich a tachasht ans a dogvis. Agus ha do wang bi fichet cat yarich an legal amach ans an skir a gach bliena sin al di chach. Get the ha cat yarich ast ans a vana grui, a hayat aun an kurnasht fo cat edel, genius agus lwudachi arenya. Although there is already a population of wildcats in the Cairngorms, it is under threat and close to extinction due to interbreeding with feral domestic cats, disease and habitat loss. This licence that was being given to the two groups was considered in line with the Scottish Code for Conservation Translocations, looking at issues including animal welfare, site suitability and potential impacts on neighbouring and community interests. Chayen kedichas a horsh gan fach adeir cúshin mar slanchin an bachin, co rechas chan skira, agus bachin ir a chorishnach agus bachin ella san skira. Ruig na cael chan kiel na creca a hafashk ir an ugi vod. The wildcats were bred at the Highland Wildlife Park in Kincraig, near Aviemore, and will be released in a 600 square kilometre area, which is part of a project to enhance habitat species and ecological processes in the Cairngorms. Once there, according to Nature Scot's head of biodiversity, Dr. Catherine Lees, the wildcats will face further challenges in order to survive and thrive, and the project will be working with local communities, farmers, landowners, and cat owners. As J gave a legal amount hounds and skira, a sheer cared kilometre and a gacha, B yet shin nakach yerich, a tahirstri dulun ella. I guess hedge and thrachig le baunan munyal GPS. After their release, the wildcats will be monitored using GPS collars. So you might say these cats who've been bred in captivity are being let out of a bag in the Cairngorms. So with that in mind, let's listen to Alistair Fraser playing The Cat in a Bag. Thank you. caramount all of Kashikan and Park Avani Roy Catch Yerich Eichen Hayol Kenegiriara Gunavi Alarg Caparin Kalia had to giri in the look Kashik Shak Nakach Yerich. So while visitors to the Kangums might stand a better chance of seeing wildcats in the future, they're being asked not to go searching for one of Scotland's rarest birds, the capercaillie. Capercaillies are a large woodland grouse whose numbers have fallen recently to the lowest level in 30 years, with fewer than 600 left in Scotland. About 85% of those live in the Cairngorms National Park. She shows the gown, colicrikiach, gahoun and capercaillie, ach, chaniel, ach, sheer, ket, you, erakel, and laupa. I guess in kutchas mo, you, aunum park, avani, roe. A capercaillie guma, juge, I guess beate. Trich, a chassiv, ounds the craven, nyo, facharn, e war, a chalye. Capercaillies are described as very shy and elusive birds, often perching in trees or hidden on the forest floor. Except during the spring mating season, when male capercaillies gather at sites known as licks to compete for female attention. Ach, chavin na caper and collar, ha juge as yerach, na revias farapishan aln. Etten a finnish, a fell lek. Ha taramischa is a milagel avi a dull ran hachikan leki. Lekig, na hachikan leki. Ach, a ranyan shin ha yemersh town etten a mayan and sorcelta avi lek it be. Which is a terrible pun. Lek it be, lek it be, lek it be, lek it be. Leave the capercaillies alone, let it be, let it be. If they're not using that song, they should. It is illegal. I don't know if I've already said the English section of this. It is illegal to disturb capercaillie during their breeding season, but people apparently still need to be reminded, and this year it is through a campaign called Let It Be. So if I didn't already say the English bit, I'm sorry for the non-Gaelic speaking listeners who just Gaelic, randomly singing. But that's what it was about. There's a campaign called Let It Be to stop people disturbing capercaillie mating sites. Yes, let's go to another song. In fact, I was going to play Capercaillie's The Tree. I might save that for later. Instead, let's listen to Let It Be, but you can imagine that it's saying Let It Be, and it's about not disturbing capercaillies during their spring mating season, because they are, as I've mentioned, Scotland's rarest bird, fewer than 600 of them left in Scotland. Police are appealing for information after a red kite, a protected species of bird, was shot on Monday last week on the Lochendorup estate near Grant Tenapons Bay in the Highlands. Chai runa achuri bialavan ruag shosu yo and glacier jiluan shochai ed woch and darup ed railtach. Ur an SSPCA grim ed echkan union achro roata ach va anien du lionach agus vashe. The bird was recovered by the SSPCA shortly after it was shot, but had to be euthanised due to its injuries. Red kites became extinct in Scotland in the 19th century and have been successfully reintroduced, but it is illegal to injure or kill them. Chai bialvan roig a bi aunan alopas an naiv lín jeag. Ach, haan a gittar ash le coi dynias an lín siochai. Ach, haa taramischa Nahyan Alyonag Nya Avaravak Hucht Ras Machyan Stirichavani Ha ek Gach Dunya Achudjachik Anai Iakish Mar Shah Habas Ian Anansiachik Mar Shah Gwe Drugal. Ross Ewing, the Moorland Director at Scottish Land and Estates, said everyone should do all they can to assist in tackling raptor crime, and the death of a protected bird of prey in these circumstances is deeply concerning. And as well as being illegally shot, wild birds also have to worry about bird flu. Ha avarachir gunachin, ha ekioin iagich the drag a ravel a her genius. Ha nature scot ek natin than yon eichin aunan le chiet gne yon, fechion toshich feliach. Agus ha plana ach a creachin a chuit ir an genius. I'm sour of shock. Chiang. Nature Scott has recorded bird flu in more than 50 different species this year alone, and have a plan to limit its spread over the coming summer migration season. There's a surveillance network which measures the impact of bird flu on seabird colonies, including antibody sampling on barnacle geese populations in particular, to find out whether they have built up a resistance. And it's time for another song. So I'm going to go back to the story in the previous segment, which was about capercaillies, and we'll now listen to capercaillie, the music group, singing a song called The Tree.
Thank you.
Ha shivagas jachri uid rèidio albannach astràilia-a-deas coig I bia in 93.9 FM ar digitach I bia wordas rig eid in linea. You are listening to Scottish Radio Hour on 5EBI at 103.1 FM digital EBI world or streaming online. Han program shows on naiach va alpa agus van tloig albannach a sha aun in astràilia-a-deas agus ar fiag na duchia. This program is for those interested in all things relating to Scotland and the Scottish diaspora here in Australia. Tás a verson teach a chur hugging agus bhí nuair bal radio, cha bhí sin ach dech dollars gach bliana. If you'd like to help us stay on air, you become a member for only $10 a year. To find out more or to get an application form, please get in touch with Jim Galloway by email at scottradiosa@gmail.com. That's scottradiosa, all lowercase, all one word, @gmail.com, or via our Facebook page, Scottish Radio South Australia. And that brings us to the what's on. What is on? Well, starting the 16th, which is nearly 2 weeks away, but Saturday the 16th of April, Port Adelaide Caledonian Society pop-up market, April pop-up market. They have one every month. It's 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. at the Port Adelaide Caledonian Society Hall, which is 189 Semaphore Road, Exeter. Now, as always, you should get in touch with Jenny Niven to find out more about it. And that's Jenny, J-E-N-N-Y, full stop, N-I-V-E-N, at hotmail.com, or by phone at 0400-896-131. That's 0400-896-131 to find out more about the April pop-up market at the Port Adelaide Caledonian Society, Saturday the 16th of April, 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. On Friday the 22nd of April, the Manapara Caledonian Society is having their social dance at the Grenville Hub, 6 Playford Boulevard, Elizabeth. That's the Manapara Caledonian Society Social Dance. To find out more about that, including the time that it starts, you should contact Lorraine Findlay at T-A-Z-D-E-V and then the numeral 1, T-A-Z-D-V and the numeral 1 at tpg.com.au, or by phone 0413 347 076, 0413 347 076, to find out more about the Manapara Caledonian Society social dance on Friday the 22nd in Elizabeth. That brings us to Saturday the 23rd, when the Port Adelaide Caledonian Society is having a pre-Anzac Day high tea. It features entertainment including small pipes from 2 to 5 p.m. at Port Adelaide Caledonian Society Hall, 189 Semaphore Road, Exeter. There will be small pipers, harp, flute and voice presenting a programme to reflect war and conflict. And as it is a high tea, there's food, let's assume catering, let's assume you have to RSVP. So in order to do that, you guessed it, contact Jenny Niven at jenny.niven, J-E-N-N-Y, full stop, N-I-V-E-N, at hotmail.com. That's jenny.niven@hotmail.com, or by phone 0400-896-131, 0400-896-131, to RSVP to the Port Adelaide Caledonian Society pre-Anzac Day high tea, the afternoon 2 to 5 p.m. of Saturday the 23rd of this month, April. There will be a very great program featuring small pipers, harp, flute and voice, presenting a programme to reflect war and conflict, because it is an Anzac Day high tea. Tuesday the 26th of April is, as usual, the Robert Burns Study Group, 7:30 p.m. in the corner room of the Burnside Council offices, which is the corner of Portrush and Greenhill Roads. It's the Robert Burns Study Group every month on a Tuesday. I think it's the third or fourth Tuesday. It's late in the month anyway. Every month. And to find out more about that, you should contact John Thornton, presenter here at Scottish Radio. And anyway, his email is johnjan4, so that's J-O-H-N-J-A-N and the numeral 4 at gmail.com, or you can contact him by phone 0409-863-235. That's 0409-863-235. Sunday, the 1st of May, the Royal Scottish Country Dance Society is having a Come and Try Scottish Country Dances, 2 to 4pm at the Mitcham Cultural Centre, Princess Road, Mitcham. And this is part of the History Festival, apparently. So that's a Come and Try Scottish Dancing. I do recommend you go and try it. I love Scottish country dancing, I love bush dancing, I love ceilidh dancing. I find it very fun. It's a skill that everyone should have, in my opinion. So if you're interested in going and trying for the first time, maybe you haven't danced in a while and you want to get back into it, do go along to the Royal Scottish Country Dance Society Come and Try Country Dances. 2 to 4pm, Sunday the 1st of May at the Mitcham Cultural Centre. And to find out more and to sign up for the Come and Try Day, you should contact Rosemary Fotheringham at secretary at rscdsadelaide.org.au. RSCDS, that stands for Royal Scottish Country Dance Society, adelaide.org.au. Or you can contact her by phone, 0423 942 936. That's 0423 942 936. And Saturday the 6th of May is the Clan MacLean Chief's birthday, 6pm banquet in Mansfield, Victoria. That's not South Australia, but I'm sure you can make the quite lovely road trip over to Victoria, visit the giant koala, visit all the sheep in Caniva, pop in and say hi to my friend Kaylee. Lots to do on the road over there. Anyway, Saturday the 6th of May, Clan MacLean Chief's birthday, 6pm banquet in Mansfield, Victoria. To find out more, to RSVP, etc, etc, please contact Ken MacLean at MacLean LIS. That's MacLeanLIS at optusnet.com.au. I'm going to spell that again. MacLeanLIS at optusnet.com.au, or by phone, and this is a landline number, so you can't text it, but you can contact him, ring him by phone, 08. If you're in South Australia, you don't need to put the 08 in there, but if you're elsewhere, put the 08 in there, 8276 8495. So 8276 8495, to find out more about the Clan MacLean Chief's birthday, 6pm Saturday the 6th of May in Victoria. And that's it for the What's On this month. And Scottish Radio are looking for more sponsors. So if you own a small business and would be interested in supporting our programme, please get in touch with us. You can have a small sponsorship announcement on the radio like the one you've just heard and reach a wider audience in the Scottish community and beyond. So get in touch with us at Scottish Radio and chat to our secretary, Jim Galloway, by email at scottradiosa@gmail.com or via our Facebook page, Scottish Radio South Australia. So give us a hand, or for the next song, the Wav, give me your hand, sung by the Ceilidh na Bliana Uaire choir on BBC Alpa, including more than half a dozen Australians, including myself, in a mass choir. 200 voices went into this next song that we're about to hear. More than 200 voices from, I think, 4 continents, including Australia. So, horan the wav, give me your hand. recorded at the end of 2020, as I mentioned. It was a socially distanced choir, socially distanced across several continents, and we all filmed and recorded ourselves separately. We filmed ourselves and we recorded our voices on nice microphones, and it was all cobbled together by the people at BBC Alpa. It turned out amazingly. Find it on YouTube. But anyway, it brings me on to a topic that I suspect a lot of listeners might not know much about, which is esports. People say singing is as much a workout as a sport. I'm not sure if that's true, and I am a singer. But anyway, esports, they're basically team competitive computer games. And they were an event at last year's Commonwealth Games, with a friend of mine even travelling from Adelaide to Birmingham to compete. Bi dyna chlwych esports, er y computer, cw farapysach, ac er y etr nasynta, is y bwai ar y gat. Chai carai chach yn gwyb Birmingham, ys pasio gael lawns na chlwych yn Commonwealth yn yr y chlwych esports. Ach, an chach yn sio, oes barenach alpenach parst awns na liorychyn iachgri. Nyr a oer eisiau amach... Nyr eisiau ystiach yn ymfarapes elite. This week, a Scottish woman made history when she became the first woman to qualify for an elite tournament. Kelsey Greig, now 22, got into esports by accident, she says, after an injury put an end to her football career. I didn't realise how easy it was to meet people, she said. Hosig Kelsey Greig, a daflian Harry Hitteris, is esports gutabastia, as j. Leonic achor stat is ora achwych. Bal kosha. Charofis ach am jay hafaris the sva dunya achanyach horshti. Ach nur hosh kia esports, chara dunya am biach gum big baranach riev maara. At first, Kelsey wasn't accepted within the esport community, with doubts expressed over how good a female player could really be. It was quite a struggle, she said. I had to prove myself, and it took me a long time. There's a lot of discrimination. She's three avowed. Bach am hialwg gyrami ma, agos farsian fat unia fwr. Halebre glio rawn. Rer esportearnings.com Chaniol baran eich am mesg na'n cehyr ced dynia a fias a fein ereget i'r art. According to esportearnings.com, there are no female players in the top 400 earners, and only a tiny fraction of the millions being won in competitions around the world is going to women. It took Kelsey a while to realise the significance of qualifying for the Challengers Elite, but once she did, she said, it was incredible. But the main thing I've taken from it is, if I can do it, hopefully other females can. I might be the first female to do it, but hopefully I'm not the last. Fa'r un iawn must have eich Kelsey na reini. Fa'r dochred yn eich hwrsdi. A chaning sa, ma sy'r eon sy'r eon of And we're nearly at the end of today's programme, so just a few moments to mention that there is a new First Minister in Scotland, Hamza Yousaf. Now, I've been following the career of Kate Forbes, who actually came second in the leadership bid and has now left politics entirely, which I was a little disheartened to see because... Well, she's a woman, she's also a Gaelic speaker, and she's campaigned a lot for the rights of Highlanders and Islanders in the Gaelic-speaking community in general, so I was a bit sad to see her go, but the new First Minister is Hamza Yousaf. This is still an SNP government over in Scotland. And that's about all we have time for today. Here on Scottish Radio Hour at 5 UBI 103.1 FM, Marshin, Shine Vons and Ish Van Ud Radio Alpanach Australia Jesic Coic EBI and Yonitri Punkin FM Chirian Drasta Agus Sari Live He Shin Shiv Ana Yachking Ach Na Falaviv Ferechiv Son Ud Radio Eranach Ekle Ud Scottish Radio Hour will be back at the same time next week. And of course, don't forget Celtic Radio Hour at 5 PM on Saturday. And in fact, why go anywhere now? Stick around and listen to our friends at Irish Radio Hour coming up shortly at 1:30. And until then, here's Austral playing Thylacine. It's Tasmanian Tiger. Austral, Australian band. Good music. Here we go. Gideon Drasta. sin é bhfuil an sa anois.